In this video, you'll learn to easily configure and control your Pepwave AP One access points using the Peplink Balance WLAN Controller. Depending on the model, the Peplink Balance allows you to configure as many as 500 AP One access points with just a few clicks. In our example, we'll be setting up 4 access points in an office with 2 floors. On the first floor, we have a single AP One for guests and staff, and we've installed 3 AP1s for staff and management working on the second floor. As you'll see in the upcoming 5-part demonstration, the Peplink Balance WLAN Controller makes it easy to set up and control a network perfectly tailored to your customers and employees. To start, select the Network tab on the top menu. Next, click AP Management, located in the WLAN Controller section at the left side of your screen. To turn on AP Management, check Enable. To manage an AP One installed on a remote network, check Manage Remote AP. You can also set up a list of recognized AP One devices. To do that, click Access Points listed below and enter each device's serial number. To store your changes, click the Save button. Then, make your changes active by clicking Apply Changes. Next, you'll see the Dashboard page, which displays a list of all automatically discovered AP One devices on your network. Now that we've enabled and detected all AP Ones on the network, it's time to create and configure separate wireless networks for guests, staff, and management. To get started, select the Network tab from the top menu. Next, click Wireless Networks. Then, click the New Network button. In our example, we've already created wireless networks for our managers and staff. Now, we'll create a network just for guests. In the Wireless Network Settings section, enter a network name. We'll call ours Guests, though you can use any name you'd like. The Security Policy menu features WPA-WPA2 personal encryption, which we've used to protect our staff and manager networks. For larger businesses using external password authentication servers, there's also WPA and WPA2 Enterprise Security. Though we recommend password protecting most networks, our guests should be able to access the Internet without entering a password. In this case, we'll select Open from the Security Policy drop-down menu. Then, we'll tweak our network's advanced settings to provide a greater measure of security, while still making it easy for our guests to get online. To prevent guests from accessing our local server, we'll check Block All Private IP in the Guest Protect section. If you'd like to manage bandwidth usage in your networks, you can set bandwidth and user limits in the Bandwidth Management section. By checking Captive Portal, you can display custom splash screens to your Wi-Fi users. This is a great feature for building your brand and ensuring that users of your public Wi-Fi networks have accepted your terms and conditions. When you're happy with your new wireless network settings, click OK to create the network. Now that we've successfully created and configured our wireless networks, let's move on to creating access point profiles. AP Profiles allows us to combine and configure wireless networks, as well as letting us assign various networks to specific AP One devices. In our example, our first floor AP One should have separate profiles for guests and staff. We'll start by clicking the AP Profiles link. Next, we'll click the New AP Profile button. Let's call our new AP profile First Floor. Each AP profile can include up to 4 wireless networks, though we'll need just 2 in our example, one for guests and another for staff. In your AP profiles, you can optimize your AP One's radio performance using the options in the Wi-Fi AP Advanced Settings section. You might, for example, select a different 2.4 GHz radio channel to eliminate potential channel conflicts. We finished creating our AP profile, so we'll click Save to store it. Now let's have a look at the AP profile for the second floor. As you can see, we've chosen the Manager and Staff wireless networks for this profile, which features its own settings and password. After clicking Save to store our changes, we'll click Apply Changes to make them active. Now that we've created our AP profiles, it's time to assign them to our access points. Let's start by navigating to the dashboard. Next, we'll click the Control Panel button found in the WLAN Information section. To apply the first floor AP profile, we'll locate the listing for the AP One on the first floor of our office and check its box. Then, we'll select AP Profile from the drop-down menu in the lower right corner. In the AP Profile dialog box, we'll select the previously created first floor AP profile and click OK. The selected AP profile is then assigned to the AP One located on the first floor. Now we'll check the remaining boxes and select the second floor AP profile. When we click OK, the second floor AP profile will be assigned to all three APs located on the second floor of our office. Let's go back to the dashboard and have a look at our new configuration. The WLAN Information section now displays the number of connected access points, as well as a number of connected users. And by clicking the Status button, we can verify AP connection name, IP address, firmware version, and more. Congratulations! You've just learned to create and configure your AP1 connections using the Peplink Balance's WLAN controller. Thanks for watching. For more information, please visit peplink.com.